Now, governors of Nigeria's opposition party, PDP, are meeting later today to subdue a fresh storm in the party caused by fresh attempts to unseat the national chairman of the party, Prince Uche Secondus, who has stepped aside in compliance with a court order that he should stop parading himself as the party's chair. For more developments on the crisis in PDP ahead of the 2023 general election, we're now being joined by Diron Odeyemi, PDP's Deputy National Publicity Secretary. Good to have you shed some light on this very topical issue.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I'm happy to be with you this afternoon.
Okay. Now, some would be asking, what exactly is at stake here? Why does it seem that some are set on getting Uche Secondus off the hot seat, and the sooner the better? We thought an impasse had been reached with the recent meetings of the PDP and the agreement to maybe move forward the convention to November. Why has this come up again so soon?
That is politics for you, and that is democracy. Where you have people having different interests, where there are competition, you are bound to have this kind of misunderstanding. I don't call it crisis, I call it misunderstanding within the party. And for the mere fact that none of the gladiators is thinking of leaving the party, all that they are doing is to exercise their power within the party. We are still happy that the party is solid and the party is supreme. So you cannot rule it out, and that is why we call it politics. 24 hours is a long time. Anything can happen. 2 + 2 outside, according to calculator, may be 4. But in politics, it's not like that. Anything can happen. So what you are seeing is the element of politics everywhere. It happens in other political parties. That is human nature for you. When there is competition, when there is different interests, they try to outwit each other. That is it. Nothing more than that. It's not a crisis per se.
So we hear the opposition governors are meeting today. What would be the ultimate good result of that meeting in terms of finding peace for this very acrimonious situation that's going on?
They are leaders of the party. And by virtue of their position as governors and as politicians, as assistant politicians, we know that they are meeting. We encourage them to take the interests of the party at heart and come out with a possible solution that will bring peace to PDP. So that's the essence of their meeting. And when you talk of politics, people will continue to meet on a daily basis. They will continue to discuss on issues. They will continue to strategize. And that is exactly the purpose of this meeting today. So they are meeting for the interests of the party and to restore peace and normalcy.
Okay, Mr. Odeyemi, you seem to be putting a brave face on it. But some might say you must be more than a little worried that people may be getting the impression that the PDP are not up to the position of an opposition party and that they may not be able to put their house in order on time before 2023 with all this infighting.
About 2-3 weeks ago, before the NEC and the governors met, this was the anticipation of the media that perhaps PDP will be out of space. They are not going to exist again. But by the time they finished the NEC meeting, by the time our governors came out, they came out with a resolution which restored peace. We can say for a certain period of time. What I'm now saying in essence is there will always be crisis. There will always be misunderstanding. Get that clear. Even in our families, we do have issues. So it's not out of place. I'm radiating confidence because I know that PDP as a political party has a special way of settling whatever is the dispute or misunderstanding among themselves. So this is not going to end PDP. We will still come out of it by the special grace of God and by the formula that the governors are going to propound. Not only the governors, the stakeholders, we all know what is at stake. We all know 2023 is near and we just must unite if we really want to win this election. And that is the permanent interest that binds all of us together, and that will always supersede personal or individual ambition.
Yes. So what would peace, what would the ultimate good goal from this look like, from this meeting that we're having today?
Yeah, we always be a common ground for the aggrieved or for the complainants and for the accused to meet and ensure that nobody's ego is bruised. In these circumstances, whether we like it or not, constitutionally, the end of this administration, I mean, Senkwadu's administration, ends on the 8th of December. And if there are agitations that, yes, we want you out of office for one reason or the other, it's still normal in politics. It is still one of those things. But the elders felt, well, instead of asking him to leave office before the expiration of the term, why not conduct the Congress in October? But for some reasons, which borders on the constitution and stability of the party, part of which is giving notification to INEC as required by the electoral law, 21 days notice. And in view of the fact that many congresses in other states have not been concluded, whereby delegates who will be voters at the national convention have not been elected, all these things put together will stop the October deadline given by the stakeholders. But that does not mean that we can still not come together and iron it out, give reasons why this October is not tenable again, and possibly postpone it to early November or wherever, or whatever. Because whatever we are playing with time, whatever it is that we are doing, by December 8th, a new administration for PDP must come on board.
Okay, well, we thank you for exuding that confidence, and we hope we don't have you back again to discuss any more crisis within the party. Dirọ Odeyemi, PDP's Deputy National Publicity Secretary, thank you.